recording crew, as we know they run a very good 10-man rotation, and they're a very deep team. What could that mean for a team looking for postseason play?
I think it's big, and I think it's really a sign of the depth this team has and how impressive that depth is. And when you have a deep team like this, it makes life a lot easier, because we saw even at the end of the game, the Bombers were still getting very positive looks. And that's trust for Dan Raven to be able to say, I can trust these people in this situation if maybe one of my starters isn't playing well.
Yeah, and definitely they have more of an expanded roster than most teams. I think they outnumbered Clarkson by a good 7 or 8 players. But they have to get trust in from their teammates and from Coach Dan Raymond that they can play meaningful minutes in meaningful games.
Yeah, definitely. And I think going forward, that's the important thing. So with that, we're going to throw it over now to Kyle DeSant, Jack Cassell and Toby Zavore, who will have your post game.
Tune in to VIC Radio every Monday from 6 to 8 p.m. to hear more songs your dad likes.
Talking about my generation, just because we get around.
Can you guys hear me?
As the midterms roll by and the tests and quizzes pile up by the day, if you feel like you're a little in over your head, consider finding yourself a free tutor in the Ithaca
Radio for post-game coverage of Ithaca College women's basketball as the Ithaca College Bombers defeat the Clarkson Golden Knights 65-32. Thank you once again. My name is Tobias Zavore alongside Jack Acello. And Jack, what a different game the second half was than the first half.
Yeah, the first half, it was definitely a close game. Clarkson Golden Knights played very well. Complete different story in the second half. I don't know what locker room speech was given, but it woke the Bombers up. An incredible second half. Final score of the second half is 35-8 in favor of Ithaca, including a complete shutout in the third quarter.
Yeah, you just mentioned it. Ithaca came right out of the half and shut Clarkson down. They weren't able to get anything going. And a team that had kept it close that entire first half suddenly wasn't able to get anything going. What did you see from Ithaca that stopped Clarkson from scoring for 11 minutes?
Just tenacious defense. They weren't giving any space. They were communicating well. They were calling out screen action switches. And they didn't let anything easy go on. They kept them out of the paint. They forced them to shoot from the outside, which they aren't good at, and they played exactly the way they want to play. That was true Bombers defense at its best.
Absolutely. And then you look at the Ithaca offense, really great job by a lot of players, but Emily Dorn leading all the scores throughout the game. And then you have players like Grace Cannon come back through, play a really great job in the second half when they didn't have as great a first half, and then other players really just stepping up for Ithaca and putting points on the board later.
Yeah, great overall game. I think Emily Dorn is definitely the MVP of this game. She's definitely the MVP of this game. She scored 14 points. She was great on the offensive glass. Finished with 8 rebounds and was tremendous on defense. She forced a couple steals as well. So great overall game for Emily Dorn.
Yeah, and for Ithaca, rebounds in the second half once again played a huge part. 51 rebounds on Ithaca's part for Clarkson, only 26. And on the offense, we talked about at the half, Clarkson had only 2 offensive rebounds going into the second half. They got only 6 throughout the entirety of the game. So for Ithaca, really great job at stopping Clarkson from getting those opportunities. And for Clarkson, just not taking advantage when they had to, just leaving points out on the floor.
Yeah, and this was a complete situation, and you see it a lot in basketball. This is an older team versus a team that lacks experience, and you really saw it at certain points in this game. Clarkson in the second half, the Ithaca's defense was being very physical with them, and they made it hard for them to get inside, and at that point, they kind of took them out of their offense, and they weren't able to adjust.
Absolutely. You talked about a little, you know, points. Dorn with 16 for Clarkson. They had 4 players put up 6, but that was the highest of any Clarkson player. Cassidy DeMond, who had led the team in points throughout the season, only got 6 points for Ithaca. Great job by the defense, shutting down the Clarkson offense. Really something that we talked about at halftime that they had to do, that they really did well in the second half.
Yeah, they just, like I said before, they didn't let them inside the paint. They forced them for outside shots. And I feel like another big thing that Ithaca did well, they didn't let Clarkson control the clock. They were getting up on them early. They were making it harder for them to get into their offense, so they didn't get the shot they definitely wanted. And on the offensive side, Ithaca controlled the clock very well. They started to spread the ball out a lot more. Yaman came out right away, and she was playmaking. I believe she got 4 assists right off the bat. So she did a great job on that front.
Yeah, you talk about controlling the clock at the end of the third quarter with Clarkson. just trying to put a point up on the board. Ithaca kept the ball away from Clarkson, leading to them not putting up that point throughout the third. And another important number to look at in the third quarter throughout the entire second half for Clarkson, no 3 points. They had gone 50% through the first half on through the first two quarters, but you look in the final two quarters, Clarkson goes 0 for 3 on threes. They go for 8 for 28 on field goal percentage. Clarkson just missed their opportunities in that second half, and Ithaca got some lucky breaks that they really converted on.
Yeah, and when you look at the game in total, Ithaca's game plan worked from the start. The big difference from the first half to second half was just about execution. Ithaca had a lot of turnovers that they really shouldn't have had in the first half. Sloppy passes that were too high, lollipops, rainbows, however you want to call them. They didn't do a good job in transition. They didn't get a lot of easy buckets. They cleaned a lot of that up in the second half. And they also, another big difference, they hit a couple threes right out of the gate that kind of made it, it went from a 6-point game to about a 12-point game, and it really took the confidence away from Clarkson.
Yeah, Ithaca really set that tone early. Meanwhile, Clarkson, they weren't able to have those sloppy turnovers that Ithaca made. They weren't just able to get the ball and get momentum right off the bat, and I think that played a huge part. The momentum swung such in Ithaca's way so early, Clarkson really wasn't able to get anything going, and by the time they were starting to figure out, they had been buried by Ithaca.
Yeah, too little, too late. That's exactly what it was. Once they started going in the fourth quarter, it was already about a 25-point game by the start of the fourth, so at that point, it was just too late. They did not do a good job on defense, Clarkson, in the second half. Ithaca pretty much did anything they wanted out there.
Absolutely. Ithaca got hit. If Clarkson turned the ball over 18 times throughout that game, Ithaca only 13 times. So Clarkson, especially you saw that later, they weren't able to keep the ball in their hands. That may have played a part in this game. And for Clarkson, another part, they just weren't able to play the ball well. We talked about it earlier, the importance of them just shooting well and playing Ithaca well in that second half. They just weren't able to do that.
Yeah, totally. And I agree with that 100%, and they just weren't able to hit shots. Like we said before, they just couldn't get into their offense. Shot clock is 30 seconds. I think they needed about 35 in order to get it going, so they finally were able to get the action they wanted. They went away from the pick and roll completely. Ithaca did not have to do a lot of switching, and that really led to problems for Clarkson.
Absolutely. Clarkson made some adjustments at the half that didn't quite work for them, and you look at this right here. They were 13% lower in field goal percentage than Ithaca was. They really were not putting the ball up and getting it in as much as they should have been. And that second half for Clarkson, a lot of problems, but you saw later, a lot of those younger players getting those opportunities for Clarkson and putting points up. This is a team that might have a bright future if those players start to play like they did in the fourth. They just have to kind of wait through this year.
Yeah, when you look at Clarkson right now, a young team led by Dumont, they have a bright future, but this is just a case. They went out, they played hard, it worked in the first half. A team with experience, they went to the locker room, they made the necessary adjustments, and they cleaned up their sloppy play, and at that point, playing hard just wasn't enough.
All right, and now let's take a look, kind of going into tomorrow's game for Ithaca. They're going to play St. Lawrence, and in the Liberty League standings, we talked about it in pregame, both Vassar, St. Lawrence, and Ithaca separated by just about a game apiece. Both Vassar, St. Lawrence, and Ithaca all won their games today. So tomorrow's game for Ithaca becomes really important against St. Lawrence.
Yeah, definitely, and a big factor, I think, for Ithaca, something that was great about this game, their starters did not have to play a lot in the second half. They really took care of business that first 5 minutes. If you look at people like Volpe and Cannon and Yaman, they did not play at all in the fourth quarter and pretty much all the second half of the third quarter. So they should be fresh and ready to go for tomorrow. Their opponent, they had a very tough game tonight, and they had to play a lot of their guys, and they should be a little bit more tired tomorrow.
Absolutely. St. Lawrence won 68-64 over RIT. For St. Lawrence, it's not being able to sit those players, and that can play a huge part. Their starters having to play two long days in a row, where Ithaca, as you mentioned, their top players were able to sit that last quarter entirely on the bench, and they were also able to get repetition for their lesser players, the players who haven't played as much, just get them an opportunity, and if they have to tomorrow, they'll be fresh and ready to play.
Yeah, definitely. Another person for the Bombers who stepped up today that really showed something for the future is Brady Lynch. He had a couple of big shots in that fourth quarter, so that's got to be exciting for the future for the Ithaca Bombers.
Absolutely. A great play on offense in the fourth. Brady Lynch really turned it around as a player who hadn't had a lot of impact this season for Ithaca College. He came in there and made a big impact for them this game.
No doubt. And Ithaca's future is looking very bright. They're a favorite to win the Liberty League this year, and they should be for many years to come.
Absolutely. The big test for them will be tomorrow against St. Lawrence. What do you think Ithaca has to improve on, even though they won this game great and that second half was incredible for Ithaca? What do you see Ithaca needing to improve on going into tomorrow?
Definitely need to take care of the ball better. The first half was very ugly the way they took care of the ball. And another thing is they gotta find a way to hit more shots from the outside. Like we said, coming into the day, only 28% from the outside. You clearly saw that was the case again today. They gotta find a way to hit some open threes.
Absolutely. And what do you think Ithaca is going to try and take away from this game that they did really well that maybe they hadn't been doing this season, or maybe they had been doing this season that they really stepped up in this game that they can take into tomorrow against St. Lawrence and really blow that up for a good game?
I'm going to say offensive rebounding. What they did very well today, they stayed aggressive. They were boxing out. They were boxing out the defenders and were able to get a lot of extra chances and put back with lots of fouls and more points.
Absolutely. Well, that is all the time we have for post-game coverage here of Ithaca College women's basketball as the Ithaca College Bombers defeat the Clarkson Golden Knights 65-32. A thank you to my partner Jack Casello, Evan Glotzer, Max Adams, and to everyone who made today's game possible. And a special thanks to Susan Bassett and the entire athletics department, Justin Lutz and the entire athletics communications department, General Manager of Television and Radio Operations Jeremy Menard, Sports Director Matt Sossler, Game Engineer Noah Scott, and Station Manager Chris Massacrelli. From Jack Casello and Tobias Zabori, this has been Ithaca College Women's Basketball on VIC Radio and on the Bombers Radio Network.
Hey yo, this is me, DJ K-Billy with DJ Double G, bringing to you the listeners of the good old VIC, the super sounds of the cinema.
Can you guys hear me?
At the movies, we'll keep on trucking the best music film history has to offer. From highlighting directors to showing off soundtracks and scores, At the Movies is the place for hearing the songs you love from the silver screen.
Can you hear me?
Jazz already, so I'll wrap it up quick. Because as the great Roy Shatter once said, it's showtime, folks.
When the red flashing lights on a school bus come on and the stop sign comes out, you must stop. In New York State, you cannot move again until the red flashing lights go off and the stop sign is retracted, or until the driver or a traffic officer signals it is okay to pass.
You guys aren't on air.
Opposite side of a divided highway. If you decide it's okay to risk a child's life and pass a stop school bus, you could face fines or even have your license revoked. Is it really worth it? Always obey the school bus stopping law in your state.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is DJ K-Billy with DJ Double G, bringing to you the super sounds of the cinema here on At the Movies for the VIC. Stop by for the best music film history has to offer every Friday from 11 to midnight.
At VIC, the voice of Ithaca College,
can you guys hear me in the studio?
Diversity and inclusion. We are working to ensure that more voices are heard. We support and will continue to support the Black Lives Matter movement and victims of police brutality and racial injustice. We've heard you. We support you. We must advocate for change. Black Lives Matter.
At VIC, the voice of Ithaca College, we prioritize diversity and inclusion. We are working to ensure that more voices are heard. We support and will continue to support the Black Lives Matter movement.
Can you guys hear me? I can't hear you.
And racial injustice. We've heard you. We support you. We must advocate for change. Black Lives Matter.
I love to ride my bike so I can feel the wind through my hair.
Hey, kid! Wear a helmet!
No way, Grandpa, because then I'm looking like an idiot. Ah!
The majority of bicycle deaths are due to head injuries. Helmets reduce the odds of a head injury by 50%. Don't be a dummy. Wear a helmet.
I'm getting a catcher's mitt.
I'm getting ice skates.
I'm getting a jigsaw puzzle.
I'm getting dying coral reefs.
A blue bicycle.
Can you guys hear me?
I'm getting a severe drought.
Okay, for some reason it wasn't working. How much time do you guys want?
A killer heat wave.
All right, you guys got 15 seconds.
I'm getting a devastating flood.
Sorry about that.
So generous. We're even giving kids global warming, but it's not too late. We can still reduce greenhouse gas pollution.
You guys got 5 seconds.
Globalwarming.com. Brought to you by Environmental Defense, the Robertson Foundation, and the Ad Council.
for VIC Radio. This is a presentation of Ithaca men's basketball. Ithaca Bombers up against the Clarkson Golden Knights. For Alex Chiprut, I am Parker Hollandoner. Thank you for joining us tonight. Alex, we are seeing a rematch of a game that happened earlier this season where, shockingly, the Clarkson Golden Knights, who are now on the season, a very upset 5-16, whereas the Ithaca Bombers are now 13-7, looking to advance to a better spot in the Liberty League. How do you look at this game?
Absolutely. I think I look at it as a huge opportunity for the Bombers. This is a must-win game for them. If they win this game, they will draw even with the Star for second in the Liberty League standings. And coming in with only four games left in the regular season, this is an absolute must-win game. And I think that Ithaca will learn from its mistakes last time and not overlook this team.
I gotta agree with you there. This is absolutely a must-win game for the Bombers. And you pointed out something to me right before we came on air, that last time the Bombers played this game against Clarkson, they did not have their star player. Tell us a little about that.
Yes, Luka Radovich did not play against Clarkson last time they met in the regular season, and he will be returning for this game. And I think that is absolutely pivotal for Ithaca. I think he is one of the key cogs for this offense, and I think they will look to get the ball to him often and early.
Now, obviously, the Bombers are coming off a huge triple overtime win at Skidmore that happened last weekend, where they were able to pull it out 101-99, and that is probably a proponent of their offense being the number one scoring offense in the Liberty League, scoring 79.3 points per game, in addition to having the number two margins, where they are winning their games by an average of 7 points. What do you think the keys are going to be for Ithaca to take this win?
I mean, absolutely, you said it, they're the leading scorer in the Liberty League, but I also think it's just about getting the ball to their stars. I think getting Luka and Skyler Sinan the ball early and often will be big for them. Also, I think they're letting in a lot of momentum coming off of a grindy game like that. That is a huge emotional boost for them coming off of a triple overtime game.
I gotta agree with you there. Plus, they've had almost an entire week to rest up, so it definitely feels like the Ithaca team is riding that fire right now. Could come in, whereas Clarkson, coming off of five straight losses, is trying their best to upset this momentum. And who better than the team you upset to start out the season? Maybe you can try to get some of that momentum back. But it is worth saying, Alex, Clarkson has not won a game on the road all season. How do you think they're going to try to fix that tonight?
I think this is a huge opportunity for Clarkson. They have already beaten this Ithaca Bombers team once this season. I think they need to come in here and try and lock up Skyler Sinan and Luka Radovich to try and limit that offense and definitely get some points to their star player.
Now, in terms of star players on the Clarkson Golden Knights side of the ball, we have to talk about Ryan Miles Ferguson, was the first player who jumped out to me. He's been averaging 6.2 rebounds a game, which is very, very good. He's been one of the pieces that has made this offense run, despite some faults on defense. And then on the other side, they have Blake Gearhart, number 23, the man that this entire offense runs through. If the Bombers want to win this game, they have to stop Gearhart early and often.
Absolutely. I mean, you said it. Blake Gearhart has been the key cog for this Clarkson team. If Ithaca shuts him down, it'll be a huge stop in their offense, and I think Ithaca has a really good chance of winning this game if they are able to stop Gearhart.
Now, going to what we just got to watch, you and I got here a little bit early, and we got to watch the Ithaca women's team take apart the Clarkson Golden Knights women's team in that game just before. Do you think any emotional piece comes in where the men's team is trying to get revenge for that game we just watched?
I think absolutely. I mean, we saw earlier, like you said, we saw some of the Clarkson Golden Knights on the men's side watching the women's game, and the women just absolutely were dominated. I think the Clarkson men are going to try and take some revenge for that game tonight against the Ithaca Bombers men's team.
Yep, I think you've hit the nail right on the head. This could be a very emotional game where we've seen these Clarkson players are trying their best to get up. We're seeing warm-ups right now. They're going to come out playing very physical ball, whereas the Bombers team has been very finesse-driven, with Luka being a very good shooter and a lot of their team revolving around shooting. Does this Clarkson team have a chance to just play more physical ball and perhaps get this upset?
I think absolutely. As we saw in the women's game, the most physical team won that game, and I think the same thing applies to the men. If Clarkson out is more physical than Ithaca, I think they have a really good chance to win this game. However, I do think that Luka and Skyler are going to be hard to stop for the Clarkson Golden Knights.
I will say, just my final thoughts on this. After a big, stressful win, I normally, just as a rule, expect any team to take a bit of a step back. But that said, this Bombers men's team has had almost a whole week to recover after that stressful triple overtime game. And this Clarkson team has just gotten exposed for their weaknesses. I truly think that head coach Waleed Fareed is going to take that extra step that is needed to find the holes that have been exposed in this Clarkson team and try to take this win back, get a little bit of that honor back that they lost earlier in the season. Because as we talked about, this is win or go home at this point for the Ithaca Bombers team. They control their destiny at this point and need to keep winning if they want to make it to the Liberty League, to the Division III. playoffs.
Absolutely. I mean, William Fareed, I think, needs to motivate these guys and tell them this is win or go home right now. This is for their season. This is such a key game, but I think that if he motivates them, they're going to come out playing with some fire, playing with some emotion, and I'm really excited to see how the Bombers play tonight.
All right, I think that's going to do it for us here at the Bombers pregame. For Alex Chipper, I'm Parker Hollandoner. Stay tuned for Eli Fishman and Brendan Ehrlich on the color commentary and play-by-play.
Ready to open up a jar jam? If you want to listen to new and rising artists in the jam band scene, along with some classic jams, then join me, DJ Baloo, every Sunday from 9 to 10 for Jar Jam.
Can you guys hear me?
Diving into the best tunes the jam band scene has to offer. Get ready to jam out on the BIC.
The voice of Ithaca College, we prioritize diversity and inclusion.
Can you guys hear me? Hello? Hello?
Voices are heard. We support and will continue to support the Black Lives Matter movement and victims of brutality and racial injustice.
Hello?
We've heard you.
How you doing? It's Noah right now. Mike's coming in a little later. How much time do you guys need?
Black Lives Matter.
Female artists everywhere need their voices heard. On Girl Power.
You need a minute? All right, I'll let you guys know.
From pop to rock to R&B. Tune in and support the voices of female musicians every Sunday from 10 to 11 p.m. at BICradio.org.
At VIC, the voice of Ithaca College, we prioritize diversity and inclusion.
You got about 30 seconds.
To ensure that more voices are heard. We support and will continue to support the Black Lives Matter movement and the victims of police brutality and racial injustice. We have heard you. We support you. We must advocate for change. Black Lives Matter.
You guys got about 10 seconds. You good? About 5 seconds, guys. Did you guys need more time? All right, you guys got 20 seconds. Can you guys hear me?
Yep.
All right, 10 seconds.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Ben White Gymnasium for some Ithaca College Bombers basketball as they face the Clarkson University Golden Knights. I'm Eli Fishman alongside Brandon Ehrlich up here in the booth. The third member of our team down on the floor is Jaden Becker. Before we start, let's throw it down to him.
Guys, it's great to be back here in Ben Light Gymnasium. It's great to have all these fans in attendance at this game. This is the first game since December 7th where fans from on and off campus are allowed to enter. Not that Ithaca College is now in the green when it comes to COVID protocols. Along with that, DJ Washburn is here pumping up the music. I'm sure we all heard that before. An environment that can do nothing but boost this Ithaca's team moving forward, because we all know they're definitely going to need it if they want to have a good shot at the Liberty League. Guys?
Thank you, Jaden. A big game for the Bombers today. Women's team just had a big game. The Bombers are 13-7 overall, 9-4 in the Liberty League heading into this game, while the Golden Knights are 5-16 overall, 2-12 in Liberty League. And the last time these two teams played, despite Clarkson being the underdog a little bit, they beat Ithaca. Brandon Ehrlich, my guest today, and Brandon, that first game was a big win for Clarkson. What's the momentum like coming into this game?
It was a big win for Clarkson. Clarkson only 2-11 in conference on the year. One of those wins against the Bombers. So the Bombers definitely going to be looking to avenge that loss here at home tonight.
Absolutely. The Golden Knights currently on a 5-game losing streak at the 0-10 on the road this season. But over on the Ithaca side, they are now getting a full health team. Luka Radovic back, Jack Stern back, a big-time team coming together in the success we've seen. Coming off a big win as well in triple overtime at Skidmore on Saturday. Put up 101 points.
Yeah, as you said, they are coming off a big win, and they are getting healthy at the right time. 9 players in that last game played 19 minutes. So Coach Fareed is looking to go deep into his bench in this one, and that's going to be a plus for the Bombers in what should be a close game here against Clarkson.
Absolutely, and one storyline we have to follow is Skylar Sinan of the Ithaca Bombers. He is 22 points away from his 1,000th point, obviously a major milestone. And who is defending him? Who's on the other team? It's his younger brother.
His younger brother, only a first year, so we're not sure how much he is going to play. He did play a good amount in the last time they played the Bombers, scoring 7 points. So we'll see if they put Mateo Sinan on his brother Skyler, but I think Skyler does get that 1K mark tonight. I think the Bombers know that he needs 22 points, and I think he'll get it tonight.
And the Bombers still have an opportunity to host in the Liberty League tournament. They'll need some help from RPI in the standings, but this is obviously a must-win game.
It is a must-win game. They cannot drop a game against one of the two bottom teams in the Liberty League. They're going to need this one. They're going to need to control their home floor this weekend, tonight and tomorrow, if they want a chance to host the Liberty League tournament.
Absolutely. And this team has been so great down the stretch, as I mentioned. The big triple overtime win that on this past week. George Sikoriak, Skylar Sine, and Luka Radovich, they've all each scoring at least 15 points, have all played a big part. As we're getting ready, getting set. Luka Radovich going over center to start up the game. And tomorrow, St. Lawrence. That's going to be an even bigger game for the Liberty League tournament. Luka Radovich tipping off, going against Teddy Fravel of Clarkson. Throws it up, and it's passed back to Miles Ferguson on Clarkson. Shuffles forward. Passes over to Joe Lucas. Passes back on the top right side. Now getting in is Tommy Carver, passes it back. That's Joe Lucas, pushes up, passes back to the left side of the key behind the three-point line. Now over to Chris Holbert. Some action and the fight for the ball, and the Bombers take possession. That's Mateo Sinan. Excuse me, that's George Sikoriak taking advantage. Quickly dribbles upfield. Now Radovich has it. And that's Liam Spellman shooting. Misses. Rebounded by Clarkson.
It's a great defensive stop on the first possession of the game for the Bombers, playing man-to-man defense, uptight, getting the crowd into the game early.
Blake Haber takes the ball, shuffles, passes underneath the net. Is Fravel, passes back, and now a shot from Joe Lucas, just short. So the Bombers will take possession. Lucas from downtown, a few feet to the left, behind the key, comes up short. And now taking it out is Sikoriak. Dribbles across the court, just behind the foul line. Now shuffles, passes over. That's Skylar Sinan, and he's blocked. A nice block by Clarkson, but it's rebounded by Ithaca. Guest checker has it, passes it to Sinan, who shoots, and two straight misses from Sinan, and misses by a lot. That's something we typically don't see.
But we are seeing Skylar Sinan shooting the ball. He knows he needs those 22 points to get to that 1,000 mark, and we're seeing that early.
A three-point attempt. I believe that was Gabe Murphy. Excuse me, that was Blake Gerhart. But it comes up short. Still a 0-0 game. And it's passed back to Budesheim, who passes it to Radovich under the net, and a nice layup by Luka Radovich.
Great ball movement there from the Bombers, beating the zone, finding the open man down low, and that's Luka Radovich, the first two of the ball game.
Clarkson being very, very aggressive coming out of it. That's Freddie Fravel, an attempt, but it comes up short, bounces off the rim. Luka Radovich rebounds it, passes it across to the left side of the court. And now taking it is Guest Striker. He passes it to Radovich for three.
Big time shot there from the Division I transfer, Luka Radovich. Luka originally played his college ball at Fordham, now here with the Bombers.
A Division I stint with the Fordham Rams.
Good pressure there from the Bombers, but they did commit a foul, so Clarkson will take it out still underneath their own basket.
That's going to be Joe Lucas taking it out. Looks and he passes over to Malachi Harris, who passes it back to Lucas. Now across the court, that's Miles Ferguson, who's had a great game. Passes and an attempted layup from under the net after a pass by Miles Ferguson.
And a nice take there by George Sikoriak. We're going to call a block as the defender was in the restricted area. A great take by George. Both teams being aggressive. Not much of a half-court offense so far. Both teams moving in transition.
A great takeaway by Sikoriak after the missed shot. and taking the shot will be signing for the Bombers. One is in. 6-0. Now the score. Signing another attempt on the free throw. And bounces off the rim, but it's rebounded by Ithaca, but it will be Clarkson ball. So 6-0 the score with 17:27 remaining in the first quarter.
Yeah, Luka Radovic a little bit too aggressive on the boards there. Calls for an over-the-back foul. It's already two quick fouls on the Bombers. Yes, they are up 6-0, but a little bit of foul trouble early.
That's Miles Ferguson who takes the ball, shuffles down the court, faking a three attempt. Is Hilbert. But the Bombers with a takeaway. Now at the top of the key. Passing back and forth. Trying to find a hole. It goes back to Boutchine for three from the top left part of the key. A big shot, 9-0 Bombers lead.
A big shot there by Andrew Geschichter, and the Bombers up 9-0 early. As we mentioned, this Bombers team goes 9 deep. Geschichter did not start the season in the starting lineup, but as the season's gone on, Coach Fareed has gained more trust in some of his role players, and Geschichter is one of those guys.
Now we'll go down to Jaden Becker as the timeout is called. Mike not working down there for Jaden with the timeout wrapping up. And a great start for Ithaca. Almost 3 minutes in, they lead 9-0. A big win for the women's game, too, before this. For the Bombers. DJ Washburn, as Jaden said, playing the music. A lot of energy here. Good fan base as Clarkson has the ball. Shuffling towards center court at the foul line. Passing around, Miles Ferguson has the ball, shuffles, passes back behind him, and then gets shuffled back, trying to find a hole, and a shot from number 23, Blake Gerhart, is short. Radovic picks it up, passes it to the top of the screen, and the Bombers now have the ball at the top of the key in their territory.
Yeah, great offensive rebound there by Teddy Fravel. And Clarkson is on the board for the first time in this ball game. They are being aggressive on the offensive boards.
Mateo Sinan with the ball in the top left. Takes it, dribbles, attempts a dunk, misses, but Luka Radovic rebounds it, picks it up, goes in for the layup on Sinan's missed dunk.
Radovic has been fantastic off the offensive glass. Give another two there, and the Bombers push their lead back up to 9.
11-2 now. Miles Ferguson has looked very good on the Clarkson side. He has the ball now, shoots, but there'll be a turnover before it goes in, so 11-2, and the Bombers will take possession.
Yeah, he stepped out of bounds as
stepped
the
out.
Ball did go in, so a nice play there defensively from the Bombers, and they'll bring it back into the front court with Sikoriak taking it up.
Sikoriak takes it up at the top of the key at midcourt, shuffles and passes to Geschichter, who has the ball, finds Radovic, and under the net, that was Skylar Sinan with another pair of points. 13-2, Bombers now lead.
And the Bombers continue to take advantage of that Clarkson zone, finding the guy in the middle and then finding the man, open man, down low. It's happened twice now, one time for Sinan, one time for Radovic.
Teddy Fravel, with a layup attempt, misses. Luka Radovic rebounds it again. A lot of missed shots right under the net so far.
A lot of missed shots and a lot of fouls early in this game. Both teams have committed multiple fouls, and the Bombers do have that 11-point lead here early on.
Bombers now have the ball, and Sinan, who passes it off to Sikoriak on the top left part beyond the three-point line, passes it over to Geschichter, just misses, rebounded by Miles Ferguson. He'll take it back into Bomber territory and see what he can do with it at the foul line, trying to find a hole, passes it to Hulbert, who doesn't find an opportunity, passes it back to Miles Ferguson, bounces off the rim, just too far. It's rebounded by the Bombers. Sinan takes it, passes it over to Sinan, takes the ball and shoots, but misses. Luka Radovic, though, again, another rebound and another point.
Easy work down low for Luka Radovic, the big man. Offensive board, put it back up, and then the Bombers force a turnover on the defensive side of the ball. Their defense has been hounding the Clarkson Golden Knights so far.
Another turnover. Obviously, Clarkson flustered. That was Blake Gerhardt trying to make a pass to Miles Ferguson. Passes it way out of bounds. Nowhere near, obviously, some miscommunication with 14:35 remaining in the first. 15-2, the Bombers lead. Sikoriak takes it at the top of the key. To the right, he passes to Geischecker to Sinan for two. Skyler Sinan with two more. An impressive game so far. I don't have the number in front of me, but he might have 22 by the end of today.
He might have 22 by the end of the day. That's four so far for Sinan. He has been shooting the ball a ton. I think the Bombers are looking for it, especially if they continue a blowout here.
An aggressive shot by Dante Jofield of Clarkson misses. So the Bombers rebound and take possession, but passed out of bounds by Budesheim. Very, very aggressive by Clarkson so far. They don't really set up their shots. They go to the net and try to score.
Yeah, they've been aggressive, and it hasn't worked out for them. That's why on that last possession by the Bombers, they did not have to speed the pace up. They are working. When they work slow, methodically, and get open shots, they are finding success in this game.
Teddy Fravel has the ball, passes it over to Dante Jofield, who goes in for the layup, but misses. Skyler Sinan takes possession, passes it back. Passes it back again to Jack Dalgatty. Excuse me, to Zach Reach. Sinan takes the ball again, passes it, a layup attempt by Reach, which misses.
That's a fantastic look in there from Skyler Sinan with a no-look pass to Zach Warwick. Warwick unable to finish, but he will get to go to the line for a chance at two free throws.
Two free throws for Reach. He had a double-double versus Cortland on November 11th. A couple of rotations for the Bombers. Bryce Schechter coming out.
Yeah, Tristan Wennerston coming into the ball game. Another one of these role players for the Bombers had seen more minutes as of late.
Logan Wendell coming in as well, the freshman who was the Gatorade Player of the Year in the state of Vermont last year. 18-2, Bombers lead. 13:27 remaining in the first. Clarkson has the ball in their territory, top left of the key. Passes it to Jofield, who passes it back to Holbert for three from the top left part of the key.
I think the ref's going to call that one a long two from Holbert.
A long two. That was close.
A very tough shot as well. Good defense from the Bombers. Better offense from Clarkson.
Bombers now have it. Right underneath their net. Skyler Sinan trying to find someone to pass to. Stuck in the top right. He'll try to take it himself, but passes it back to Wendell, who passes it back to Sinan, who passes it back to Reach, who makes the shot in.
Zach Warwick, the big-time scorer off the bench. The Bombers' sixth man. He can get hot at any time. That's five quick points for him.
Chris Holbert now has the ball for Clarkson. And are they going to call a foul?
Yeah, foul there on Logan Wendell. A little bit too aggressive in the low post. Wendell, one of the smaller players on the team, trying to get aggressive, trying to fight for position, got caught by the referee.
He's facing a big guy there in Garrett Delaney, 6'2", 190. Against the small freshman Wendell, a four-year age difference. As number 21, Jack Dalgetty with a two, so 21-6.
That's a great play out of the out of bounds underneath from Clarkson, finding a wide open Dalgetty for two, cutting the lead to 15.
Wendell passes it over to Jack Stern.
Stern traveled there, one too many steps. The basket did go in, but it's not going to count. A little bit too aggressive there from Stern, trying to make something happen in the post.
So Clarkson takes possession, dribbles up the court. Beyond the left wing, now passes it to Jofield, and that'll be number 30, Garrett Delaney, with the shot attempt, but way far. It's a miss, goes out of bounds, and Ithaca takes possession.
Yeah, as I mentioned in the pregame, this Bombers team goes deep. They go 9-10 deep every game, and the five starters are already on the bench here. Only 8 minutes into the game, Coach Fareed trusting his bench enough to put five bench players on the floor here. We'll see what this bench unit can do. Remember this mark, 12 minutes. The Bombers up by 15, 20.
Noah Downing coming into the game. He passes it to Wendell, the freshman, who passes it back to Larek, who shuffles and tries to pass it over to Stern, but it's intercepted by Clarkson, who takes it back up the court. And a three-shot attempt in. by Jack Del Getty for Clarkson. And a timeout is called here with 11:35 remaining in the first.
Yeah, quick timeout called there by Coach Farid right after Del Getty hit that three. Let's see if he puts some of those starters back in the game. That's a quick three there from Clarkson.
As a timeout is called, we'll go down to Jaden Becker on the floor.
Thanks, guys. And you look back at last game for Ithaca. Obviously, they were able to come out with the victory, but it took three overtimes to get there. Triple overtime game. When was the last time that's happened for the Bombers? 1991-1992 season. Unbelievably far back. It's almost 30 years in the making for a triple overtime game to happen. And I believe legs were in question for the Bombers coming into this game. Looking at the scoreboard now, obviously, the Bombers have found their legs and maybe even an icy hot or two to be able to get there. Guys?
21-9, the score of the Bombers lead.
And the Bombers are sticking with this bench unit. All five bench players still on the floor here. Bombers still up by 12, so a little bit of flexibility with that scoreboard.
11:35 remaining in the first. The Bombers will take possession under the Clarkson net. Passed up to Noah Downing with a slow dribble on the top left side. On the left wing, shuffles, takes it to the right side. Looking for someone to pass to. Takes it back to Wendell on the right wing. Beyond the three-point line, who passes it to Rarek, who tries to go underneath the net. Pass to Jack Stern with the layup for another two for the Bombers.
We've mentioned Skyler Sinan's name a lot, but now his brother Mateo has checked in for Clarkson.
Sinan on the top left side, but a three-point attempt on the Clarkson side by Reese Swenberg does not make it, goes long. Bombers take possession. Logan Wendell with a three-pointer from the top left side for the Bombers. 26-9. Now the score, extending the lead. Clarkson trying to find somewhere to go. That's Reese Swenberg. But a takeaway by Noah Downing on Ithaca. Intercepts it, smacks it out of the hand of Swenberg, and Wendell with another three-point attempt. It'll say he stepped out. Then over the net, incomplete anyway. But Clarkson will take possession, and a few more reserves coming into the game for the Bombers.
Yeah, Luka Radovic checking back in. He had a great start to this game, as we mentioned. He's checking back in for Jack Stern. Stern has been a bit banged up, so look for Coach Farid to limit his minutes, especially if the Bombers still pull away in this one.
The young Simon Mateo with the ball under the net, passes it back to Garrett Delaney, trying to make a play, looking for a shot, passes it to Sinan with, he's unsuccessful with the layup, but his teammate, Jack Del Getty, gets the layup and the rebound on his missed shot. So 26-11, now the score. Wendell at the top left, misses with a three-point attempt, and it's rebounded by Clarkson.
Wendell really likes that left corner. He's taking three balls from that spot.
And now a three-point attempt for Clarkson. In by Jack Del Getty, having an impressive game, especially from three so far. I believe that's two. He's looked very good, comfortable in the middle of the court, right beyond the three-point line.
Yes, 10 points now for Del Getty, providing an offensive force for Clarkson.
A rebound by the Bombers. Luka Radovic picks it up, dunks it in.
And there's a foul on the play. Yeah, count the basket there for Radovic, and they'll get one more at the foul line. Great, great play inside from Luka. As we've said a ton this game, he's got 11, a chance for 12 now at the line.
A big, impressive dunk by Radovic. The Fordham transfer, as we mentioned. His free throw is good after one attempt. 29-14, Bombers now lead. Simon for Clarkson, dribbles up the field and intercepted, or knocked out of bounds by Ithaca. That was Zach Rurek swatting the ball out of the air. But Clarkson takes possession again. Attempt by Blake Gerhardt falls short, bounces off the rim. Bombers rebound it in Wendell. They take the ball back to their territory. Noah Downing at the key on the left side, and a missed pass That was Zach Wierek trying to pass across, over the heads of a lot of players across the court towards the far side of the key to Wendell, but it goes out of bounds and Clarkson takes possession again.
Yeah, that's going to take Zach Wierek out of this game. Coach Freed right after that missed pass by Wierek. Wierek had two guys wide open up top and he missed them both. That'll get him a seat on the bench.
So Koryak goes back into the game for the Bombers. And for Clarkson, an impressive attempt by Gerhardt trying to get through Downing. A pump fake and a shot, good. That was Blake Gerhardt for Clarkson, 29-17 now the score. Slowly but surely, they're coming back.
And I'm telling you, there's an 100% conversion rate when a player catches the ball, fakes it, takes a dribble, and shoots it again, and Gerhardt silencing this crowd. But there has been a three right back from Tristan Wennerston, making it a 15-point ball game once again.
A nice three from the top left side for Wennerston. Ball goes back to Clarkson, 32-17 now the score. Sinan has it, making some moves. A layup attempt, batted, and a nice defensive play by Luka Radovich, taking the ball out of the hands of Blake Gerhardt. And Ithaca takes the ball back towards their territory and a three-point attempt, but looks like a foul before the three-point attempt was made.
Yeah, they're going to nullify the three-pointer there. Noah Downing a bit out of control. He's looking to be a bit aggressive, finding the open man in the corner, but the three is going to be nullified by a charging violation on Mr. Downing.
Yes, Downing was very aggressive there, especially defensively. Played a big role. As I mentioned, the Clarkson had a ball right under the net with almost nobody there, but Downing came and picked off. Clarkson shuffles, passes, Dalgetty with the ball at the top of the key. He shoots, and it comes up short. A lot of three-point attempts from this Clarkson team, who's looked more impressive right underneath the net.
Yeah, there's going to be a foul call after that missed three by Dalgetty. The Bombers will take it out underneath. But Dalgetty has been the one guy from Clarkson shooting the ball well. That's his first miss from three on the day, 2 for 3 from three. Look for him to keep shooting the ball because the Golden Knights are going to need to start hitting some threes if they want to cut into this 15-point deficit.
Sikoriak takes the ball, shuffles up to the middle of the court beyond the key in the center, passes it back to Geischecker, who shuffles to the left, right at the free throw line, passes it on the left side, but it's intercepted on a poor pass. That's Jack Dalgetty with the turnover, forcing the turnover for Clarkson. Passes it up to Joe Lucas. A nice fake, a nice pump fake. Passes it back to Chris Holbrook, but it comes up short. And Ithaca takes the rebound and will take the ball back.
Yeah, look for the Bombers to slow things down here, run their offense. They're finding great looks when they do.
Luka Radovich with a shot attempt comes up short. Logan Wendell with a nice behind-the-back pass there to set it up. But Radovich's shot misses. Clarkson takes the ball. And a sign-in, Mateo sign-in, with a nice play. A pump fake gets Radovich, who was much bigger than him in that one-on-one. Fools him, makes the shot, bounces off the backboard as Radovich takes it back for another point, 2 points for the Bombers, 34-19.
Yeah, two Bombers have to check in at the next dead ball. Spellman and sign-in, but a nice take there for Clarkson for a quick two.
Two sign-ins now on the court. And that was Blake Gerhardt with a two-pointer for Ithaca.
Yeah, they're going to call a charging violation there on Radovich. These refs are getting charge happy early in this game. That's one of the biggest 50-50 calls in basketball. Are they set? Are they not set? The charge block. They're going to get Radovich for a charging violation there. And that is two fouls on Radovich. That is something to monitor there. Both teams with five team fouls, 6:30 to go in the first half, nearing that bonus.
Radovich comes out of the game. Sign-in on sign-in on the top of the court. Passes it back to Joe Lucas, who passes it back to Gerhardt. Shuffles and intercepted. That's Jack Stern. Takes it up the court. Passes it, but another deflection and interception by Clarkson. Taking it back to the left side of the key. Mateo sign-in now with the ball beyond the foul line. Tries to make a behind-the-back pass, but it goes out of bounds, and it'll go with a possession.
Yeah, an interesting play. Both teams unable to settle the ball down there. Jack Stern running the point guard position there for the Bombers for a little bit. That was not making Coach Fareed happy on the sidelines. I doubt we'll see Jack Stern running the offense again this game.
Sikoriak now takes it to the left side of the court. Right beyond the left wing. Passes it to the right wing for Spellman to sign in. And then under the net is Stern, goes for the layup attempt. But it looks like a foul is called on Clarkson.
Yeah, it's a great play there from Jack Stern. That's where the Bombers want him. He is the biggest guy on this team. They want him down low. They want him on the block. And it paid dividends there as he is now going to head to the foul line for two shots.
Heads to the foul line. 6'7", 220. The biggest player on this court at the moment. Comes up short, very, very short with the first attempt. 34-21 the score with 5:48 remaining in the first. Stern, 168 points on the season with his second attempt. That one's good. So 35-21, now the score. Stern shooting 6-04 on the season. And Clarkson takes possession, and back into the game is Ryan Miles Ferguson, who passes it back to Mateo Sinan for three in. A big shot there from the left wing for three.
And here in Ben Light Gymnasium, the gym is split into two sides, Clarkson fan and Bombers fans. You did hear a little bit of a cheer from the Ithaca Bombers side on that one. Looks to be the Sinan family.
Andrew Geischecker tries to make a move, but a turnover. As Clarkson, he was pushed out of bounds. So Sinan, Mateo Sinan, and Clarkson will take possession at center court. Passes it over to the left wing, and a shot attempt comes up short by Chris Holbert of Clarkson. And now Skylar Sinan takes it for the Bombers. Comes back on the right wing, right three-point attempt, but it comes up short off the front of the hoop. And Clarkson will retake possession. Again, that's Miles Ferguson with a layup attempt, but it's blocked, and Ithaca takes possession again. Their defense has looked really impressive. Their offense has as well, but not as much as we've seen so far this season.
Yeah, the Bombers still on a solid pace. 35 points, 4:50 to go here in the first as the Bombers lead 35-24. Zach Warwick set to check back in here for the Bombers. A little bit of foul trouble on the Clarkson side. Two players with two fouls. You've got Joe Lucas with two, and Ryan Miles Ferguson with two. Definitely something to keep an eye on, as well as the Bombers. On the Bombers side, Luka Radovic probably going to sit out the rest of the half with his two fouls.
A little miscommunication on the Bombers side with a bad pass that was saved as Jack Stern goes for the layup, but it's blocked. A fight for the ball underneath the net. Clarkson comes up with it.
Yeah, they're going to call a foul there on Jack Stern being a bit too aggressive after he got his shot swatted away by Teddy Fravel. And a very athletic play by Teddy Fravel, not letting Jack Stern get to the basket easy.
So Clarkson and Gerhardt. Gerhardt's looked very impressive today. He's the team leader with 300 points and 14.3 points per game so far. Miles Ferguson takes the ball at the top of the key, passes to the left wing for Lucas, and then Miles Ferguson takes it back, trying to make a push, passes it back to set up the play for number 23 for Clarkson. That's Gerhardt again. Looks like that was two. So 35-27, Clarkson slowly but surely coming back. Bombers right under the net is Stern, unable to make it, a fight for the ball, and he gets overtaken by Clarkson. And Chris Holbert, who's 4 inches shorter than him, steals the ball from him.
Yeah, a little mini run here from Clarkson with Luka Radovic on the bench. Coach Freed might look to reinsert him before the half if this game gets any closer.
35-27 now. That was Miles Ferguson with a shot from the top left side of the key. Ithaca quickly takes it back. And a shot attempt by Warwick again from the top left. A three-point attempt goes over the net. Clarkson takes possession. Malachi Harris with the ball, passes it off. Back to Gerhardt. That's Harris at the top left of the key and stripped by Skylar Sinan. A turnover, behind the back pass, smooth, right to Zach Warwick. Back to Sinan. Then back to Spellman. A pump fake attempt at the 3-point line on the top left, but Clarkson intercepts it. Oh, and a great attempt for a dunk. He had an empty net, and coming from behind his back was George Sikoriak to strip the ball from him just as he was going to go up. He had an open net, but Clarkson can't take advantage. 35-27, Bombers lead. Bombers take the ball back. A three-point attempt from the right side by Larek goes over net, and Clarkson takes possession.
Yeah, a little bit of a dry spell here from the Bombers, not scoring in about 3 minutes here. So we'll see if they can get something else going right before the half, still up by 8 points.
Clarkson at the left corner, passes it back right in front of the free throw line to Fravel, but he comes up short. And Ithaca takes possession, and Liam Spellman with a three-point attempt from the right wing comes up short. Clarkson takes possession. It's back and forth. Missed shot, missed shot.
Yeah, despite missing that shot, I like that look from Liam Spellman. Get him involved. He's been the least used player on this Bombers team so far.
A nice deflection on a pass attempt by George Sikoriak. Goes up for the layup with a nice play on the empty net. Deflects the ball. Deflects the ball, picks it up, sprints to the net. With the empty net, takes advantage, 37-27. For a second, looked like Clarkson was making a comeback. They had a few unanswered points, but that's a big point right there for the Bombers.
Eli, that's what we like to call defense into offense. George Sikoriak getting the deflection and then going with a smooth right-handed layup on the left side to push this Bombers lead back to double digits at 37-27 with 1:59 to go here in the first half.
1:59 to go here. And Coach Marie Farid for the Bombers pumping up his team. In a quick talk. George Sikoriak too at the center, talking to his team.
Yeah, this huddle, we're sitting right over this huddle here. The Bombers look intense, they look focused, they're ready to go and close this final 2 minutes of the first half strong.
Obviously, you feel like you have a chip on your shoulder when Clarkson, a team that they know they should have beat, 82-71 the last game they played each other. Ithaca fell. Definitely something you have in the back of your head in a big important game like this. Revenge, a place in the Liberty League tournament on the line here.
Yeah, the Bombers know they can't drop this game. They can't give Clarkson 3 wins in the conference with the Bombers being 2 of those. The Bombers are a better team than that, and they want to extend their in-conference record to 10-4 here today.
Ithaca 9-4 going into today, their third. Vassar and RPI, the only 2 schools ahead of them. And Clarkson with 2-11 is at the bottom of the conference. A game they have to win. You can't afford to drop a big game like this to a team at the bottom of the conference. For Clarkson, Blake Gerhardt with a layup attempt. It's in. 29-37. Bombers still lead. A nice job there by Clarkson, being very patient, setting up that layup by Gerhardt. Bombers now have it, sign in. A three-point attempt is no good for the Bombers. That was Tristan Wennerston.
There's a foul down low on Clarkson. That's going to be the 17th foul, so a 1-1 here. I believe Noah Downing was fouled. Yeah, it is Noah Downing, so he will shoot a 1-1 here.
Downing, 35 points, 15 rebounds, and 8 takeaways on the season. We've seen it so far today. An impressive defender. Chance for a point here for the Bombers. Bounces off the backboard, and Miles Ferguson takes possession. But the pass is deflected and picked off by Wennerston, who brings it back, passes it to Downing. He passes it back to Wendell. Skyler Simon with a behind-the-back pass and a dunk attempt by Tristan Wennerston for 2. Simon with a clean behind-the-back toss. And Wennerston goes up, goes over the defender. 39-29, Bombers now lead.
You've seen a good amount of flair from the Bombers on the offensive side of the ball. I think that's now 3 behind-the-back passes. This one results in an easy layup, and the Bombers back up by 10.
Jay Lucas with another behind-the-back pass of his own to Miles Ferguson, who passes it over to Chris Holbert with a layup. So 39-31, an impressive play right there again. 2 straight possessions where they go and make an impressive layup. Clarkson. Sinan at the top of the key, passes it over to Wendell, a 3-point attempt. He loves that spot on the back left corner. That's his 4th or 5th time going for a shot there.
Yeah, only a 2-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock, as the Bombers will retain possession here. 19 on the game clock, 17 on the shot clock. Look for the Bombers to work the shot clock down, find the best shot possible, and make this potentially the last shot of the half.
Skyler Sinan in the right corner will take possession with 19 seconds remaining. Passes it to Stern, passes it back to Sinan, passes it back to Dal Getty on the right wing. 7 seconds remaining. Passes it up to Downing for 3. It falls short. Stern tries to pick it up, but Mateo Sinan of Clarkson tries to make an attempt And before Clarkson can get under the net and get a point, the clock runs out, and we'll head to halftime. 39-31, Ithaca College Bombers leading Clarkson.
Yeah, great half there from the Bombers. It looks like Jaden Becker has got Waleed Fareed coming over to him, so we'll send it down to Jaden in a second. It's a very impressive half from the Bombers here so far, as they are doing what they have to do. They're up by eight. They know they need this game, and we'll send it down to Jaden now.
Here, head coach Reef Reed. Coach, an eventful first half, to say the least. A couple emotional timeouts as well. What was your message to your team throughout those timeouts?
I just try to keep the intensity up. You know, we let up a little bit in terms of our aggressiveness on both ends of the court, and we let them back in it. So just trying to get the guys to stay intense and understand every possession matters.
Obviously, the second half, score right now at 39-31. The lead was much larger earlier on in the first half. What changed throughout the first half?
I think they got comfortable. We took our foot off the gas a little bit. We missed some shots that we should probably make, hopefully, in the second half. I think we got to take care of the ball. A couple careless turnovers gave us some life.
Thank you, Coach.
You got it.
Thank you, Jaden. 39-31, the Ithaca College Bombers lead the Clarkson Golden Knights. Heading into halftime, we'll turn it over to our pre-half and post anchors for Brandon Ehrlich and Eli Fishman. We'll be back with you when the second half begins.
Hey, what are you doing?
Putting down a layer of asphalt.
Well, it sounds terrible.
Hold on.
Wow, this sounds better. What is it?
This is Asphalt, VIC's 90s alternative and indie rock show. Check it out every Wednesday from 10 to 11, only on VIC. Hey you, do you like Stephen Malkmus or Pavement or Stephen Malkmus and the Jicks or any other Stephen Malkmus related projects? We've got it all here on Asphalt from VIC every Wednesday from 10 to 11 here on commercial-free VIC.
At VIC, the voice of Ithaca College, we prioritize diversity and inclusion. We are working to ensure that more voices are heard. We support and will continue to support the Black Lives Matter movement and victims of police brutality and racial injustice. We've heard you. We support you. We must advocate for change. Black Lives Matter.
Alex and Parker, can you hear me? Okay, I'm going to send do one more PSA after this and send it to you guys.
Join us every Friday night at 10 as we explore the best of folk and Americana.
It'll be about 10 seconds left in this, and then the PSA is probably around 30 seconds.
Along the way, sit back and enjoy the view, only on VIC Radio. At VIC...
Okay, it's actually 20 seconds. I'm going to play a little music, and then I'll get you in. I'll count you guys down.
We are working to ensure that more voices are heard. We support and will continue to support the Black Lives Matter movement and victims of police brutality and racial injustice. We've heard you. We support you. We must advocate for change. Black Lives Matter.
Okay. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Welcome back to the gymnasium of the college men's basketball. The Bombers taking on the Clarkson Golden Knights. Alongside Alex Chippert, I'm Parker Hollandunner. Thank you for tuning in. The score at the half is 39 Bombers, 31 Clarkson. Alex, the game's been off to a pretty good start for Ithaca, but then Clarkson started to come alive once the first half started wrapping up. What do you think about the game so far?
Absolutely, you said it. I mean, Ithaca started off super strong. Lugarevich had a phenomenal first half, 14 points in the first half, 9 points early. He hit all of his shots and has been dominating on the boards for Ithaca. However, Clarkson definitely woke up towards the end of this first half, and they started hitting shots from three, and that has really turned the game around for Clarkson.
Oh, yeah, we fully agreed. Luca woke up feeling dangerous today. Only played 10 minutes so far, but he's already put up 14 points, the majority of the Bombers' points as of now. That said, they have been spreading the love around. We've been seeing number 11, Noah Downing, playing great two-way ball is someone that I really noticed. But I believe you noticed, you pointed out to me, there's been one piece that has really been key to this entire game so far.
Absolutely. I mean, they have been just dominating on the boards. I think that has really led to this. I mean, they are out-rebounding Clarkson by a large margin, both on the offensive and defensive boards. This has led to Ithaca's lead, and it honestly led to their early lead early in the first half.
Yeah, but we did see that start to slip away towards the end. We saw the defense tightening up on the Clarkson side. We saw Jack Dougherty starting to hit his shots as well, with Blake Gearhart, who we talked about as the core of this offense. He started returning to form. He started hitting some of those threes. As soon as we started on the sidelines saying maybe this Clarkson team came out cold, they proved us wrong. They came out wanting to play spoiler in this game, as we talked about.
Absolutely. I mean, you said it. Blake Gearhart has been mostly contained so far for the first half, and like you said, Noah Downing has done a really good job of doing that, but he did wake up towards the end of this first half, and the Ithaca Bombers really need to hope to contain him in the second half in order to preserve this lead. I also think they need to start getting Skylar Zinen going along with the rest of the offense, because it really has just been Luka so far. I think they need to spread the wealth around a little bit more in order to get everyone their shots, not just Luka.
I could not agree with you more. Now, if you were the Golden Knights coach, Jeff Gorski, and you're in the locker room right now, what are you saying to your team?
I'm saying, guys, this is a team that we can beat. We are only 8 points behind them, and this is a chance to send them home and end their season right here, right now. Let's go out there, play physical, play aggressive, and go after this team, because this is their season on the line right now. We have no pressure on ourselves.
I could not agree with you more. So far, like you said, Ithaca has come out. They've been running their offense largely through one man, Luka, as always. But they've also been playing very good defensive ball, but that's both of those started slipping towards the end of that first half. So at this point, do you think Clarkson smells blood in the water?
I think they do, because, I mean, like you said, Ithaca definitely trailed off towards the end of this first half. I think that Clarkson needs to come out of this half and just play super aggressive and take advantage of the blood that is in the water. They are only down 8 points right now, and that is definitely a manageable lead that they can definitely make up in the second half.
Now, something else going to the Bombers' credit right now, they have not committed any shooting fouls. Clarkson has not gotten to the line yet tonight, whereas Ithaca, on the other hand, is 4 for 9 from the free throw line. No massive number, but do you think that could play a factor in how this game shakes out?
I think that definitely does. Clarkson can get into foul trouble into the second half, and I think that could definitely play limiting some of their players. Also, I think that the fact that Ithaca has played very, very clean ball, very limited fouls, like you said, helps them to keep this lead and helps them from getting 3 points on the line for Clarkson.
Now, I want to ask you this, because it is something very interesting. We obviously have the stat sheets pulled up, and Ithaca is dominating in every statistical category, and yet this game is as close as it is. What do you think is allowing the Golden Knights to keep this game as tight as it's become?
I think it's been the three ball so far. Clarkson started shooting out early in the first half very poorly from three, but they really turned it on towards the end of the first half, and Ithaca quite vice versa. Ithaca started shooting very, very well from three at the beginning, and it has tailed off towards the end of this first half.
Yeah, as I pointed out earlier, Dougherty, number 21 for the Golden Knights, now 4 of 5 from the field and 2 of 3 from three. Gearhart, obviously, one of two from three and 3 of 7 from the field. So, yeah, shooting definitely did pick up towards the end of that first half. Are there any other players who really caught your eye coming out of this first half?
I think definitely Noah Downing, like you said, definitely caught my eye with his two-way play. I think he's been great for the Bombers, but I also think Dougherty has really been the star for Clarkson so far. Gearhart has been contained for the most part, and I think the Bombers need to keep that up and also shift their focus a little bit towards Dougherty in order to keep the Clarkson offense contained.
Now, while obviously Luka Radovich has been a lot of the defensive production, the other shout-outs do have to go to George Sikoriak, the third, who has been playing absolutely amazing, number 5, and also number 4. Number 4, Andrew Geschichter, has been playing absolutely amazing defensive ball. Both of them have been contributing to what we talked about, which was that amazing rebound game on both the offensive and defensive sides of the ball, where we've seen Luka get his own boards. We've seen a lot of other players making up for missed shots. So, what does Ithaca need to do to hold the ship together going into this second
half? I think
they
need to keep the dominance on the board. So far, that has been their go-to, and that has allowed them and Luka to get it going. And I think that they really need to keep the pressure on the boards on Clarkson in order to really be more physical against this Bombers team. I think the Bombers have come out and really been physical against Clarkson and kept the boards on their side.
Last point, really. This has been a bit of a mistake-riddled game for both sides of the ball. We've seen major passing failures on both sides, a lot of turnovers on both sides. Do you think that is going to be what decides this game, or do you think it's just a minor issue since both teams are committing the errors?
I think it's a minor issue, considering both teams are pretty equally doing turnovers. We saw both sides make some poor passes, make some poor turnovers, but I think that that can both be cleaned up by both sides. I don't think that'll come down to it. I really think that the boards is the key to this game.
All right. I think that's going to do it for us here at Bombers Radio Network. For Alex, I'm Parker Hollandoner. Stay tuned for the second half of this game, Ithaca men's basketball versus the Clarkson Golden Knights.
It's been a long day. So why not take the scenic route home? Tune in for a variety of folk music every Friday, 10 to 11 p.m. Right
here. Let me know when you're on headset.
It's important to make sure your family has a plan in case of an emergency. We talked to this family to see if each of them knew where to meet if they were not together when something happened.
If a natural disaster happened when we were outside the home, we would all meet at the park. That's our meeting point.
Our meeting place is our neighbor's house because she is my mom's good friend. We all have a meeting spot, which is...
You on headset?
Is your plan any better? To learn more about making an emergency plan for your family, go to ready.gov. This message brought to you by the U.S. Department of Homeland Security and the Ad Council.
I'll take FM Alternatives for 1,000.
This indie alternative radio station provides listeners with the best of what's next.
What is VIC Radio?
That is correct.
Hey, can you hear me?
Yeah, Michael, I got tunes.
Okay. I'm gonna send you back after this thing, okay?
Stay with me.
So 15 seconds left in this, and I'll play music for a little bit, and I'll count you down.
Hey, want to listen to all these tunes and more? Tune in to Marble Soda every Wednesday from 11 p.m. to 12 a.m. on VIC Radio.
Nice job. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Welcome back to Ben Light Gymnasium here. Brandon Ehrlich and Eli Fishman, we're here with you for the second half for Clarkson and Ithaca. Clarkson trailing the Bombers here. Bombers up 39-31. Eli, what stood out to you in that first half of play from the Bombers?
From the Bombers, their offense definitely stood out in a few ways, some positive, some negative. They definitely looked like a team that set up their passes, definitely a lot of patience, definitely they waited a lot. And then in some circumstances, especially on the defensive side, you know, we saw it a couple times with Noah Downing, we saw it with Jack Stern, they come up aggressive, fighting for the ball, jumping on top of each other, a little bit hectic at times, and as Coach Reed told Jaden at halftime, there was definitely a little bit more aggressiveness, a few more fouls than you would like.
Yeah, look for the Bombers to continue to push that gas in the second half. We'll get back down to Jaden Becker in a bit, but the Bombers up by 9, they've had a kind of top-heavy scoring attack. Radovich leading the way with 14 and not much else on the offensive side of the ball.
Tristan Wennerson with 5 points as well. Skyler Seinen with 4. And his brother on the other side, Mateo, has looked very impressive as well, coming in as a first-year for 5 points for him. Jack Dalgetty, as we mentioned, I think he had 2 threes in that first half. Was very, very impressive, especially, you know, relying on this left side of the key, coming in, setting up a lot of great plays. Ryan Miles Ferguson, again, looked very, very impressive. One of those, you know, smaller guys that makes a lot of quick moves, gets the ball under the net.
Yeah, but Eli, as we mentioned pregame, 2 storylines we're monitoring, both involve Skyler Seinen. One, he needs 22 points to get to 1,000 career points. He still needs 18 in the second half, not sure he's going to get there. But how about the battle of the Seinens? You mentioned it. Mateo, 5 points. Skyler, 4 points. Who would have thought you would have been saying that? Mateo leading the way for the Seinen duo.
You wouldn't have thought it. And you always say with these college basketball games, there's sometimes a 4 or 5 year difference between players on the court. You know, the younger Seinen, Mateo, 5'10", 165. He's going up a guy. He was going up for a second against Jack Stern at 6'7", 220. 4 years older than him.
What's one thing you're looking for in the second half from the Bombers' end?
Defense. I think Clarkson took advantage when they needed to at some points in terms of the defense for them. But there were a few points where Clarkson got a little bit careless with their offense and didn't make shots they should have. But Ithaca needs to not allow those shots to happen. They had way too many open nets, easy shot attempts.
And I think if the Bombers were the smarter team in the second half, they will prevail in this ball game. Let's send it down to Jaden Becker. Jaden, what do you got for us?
Thank you, guys. I want to speak a little bit more on Luka Radovich. After spending 2 seasons playing college basketball at the D1 level, Radovich transferred from Fordham University to Ithaca College and has transitioned smoothly into a prominent role on the South Hill. Radovich, when speaking with the Ithaca, said, quote, "I think we got a really good ball rolling right now." He also said, quote, "Guys are stepping up big time. They're finding their roles and they're doing what they're capable of doing. So I think everyone's locked in and committed, and this team can achieve something special." Obviously himself achieving something special, averaging 16 points per game, currently at halftime at 14. Guys?
Thank you, Jaden. As DJ Washburn plays Pepis over Ben Light Gymnasium.
Classic.
It is a classic as the second half is set to get underway. Coach Farid drawing some stuff up in the huddle for these Bombers. The Bombers look intense. They look focused. They look ready to go. Eli, are you ready for the second half? What do you think is going to happen? Do you think the Bombers can pull it out here?
Absolutely. I think the way they've looked so far, consistency. That's just the one word they need to rely on, consistency. As I said, they were inconsistent a little bit with aggressiveness, inconsistent with setting up, and a bit inconsistent in the spot that they were running up to the net and shooting it, as opposed to, you know, setting it up, especially when they had a good opportunity to run some schemes. And I think that's what Coach Farid has been talking about. That's, I think that's definitely what they're going to switch up a little bit. And Radovich as well definitely stands out on the score. He's been very impressive, shooting 495 this year, 90 for 182, and 696 on free throws.
So the Bombers will inbound as well. Second half coming right to left. Sikoriak with the ball, top of the key. Bombers running their offense, quickly down low to Radovich. Double teamed, hit on the arm, no foul called, and the ball is taken by Clarkson.
That was an interesting no foul call there on Clarkson. That was Reese Swedberg trying to swat the ball from Radovich. Hit him a little bit, but no call.
He certainly did hit him. That was a great play call out of the timeout by Coach Farid. As Clarkson's on the board here in the second half, early, Chris Holbert with the two.
A nice shot from Holbert, fade away.
And a quick turnover down the other end. The Bombers turning it over off Skyler Simon's leg. And this is the exact start Clarkson was looking for coming out of the halftime locker room.
Some miscommunication there by Ithaca. That was Liam Spellman passing it behind Simon and off his foot.
And for the first time in a while, Clarkson with a chance to cut this game down to a single possession as they trail 39-33 here in the early stages of the second half. Clarkson going left to right, to top of the key, moving the ball around, eight to go on the shot clock, shot fake from Lucas, Lucas drives, doesn't know where to go, gets it off, one on the shot clock, and the layup is up and good. That's a heartbreaker. Blake Gerhardt with the layup, and the lead is down to four.
Luka Radovich folded on that one, was right under the net trying to block it, but definitely got outplayed there and led to that 2 points with 1 second left on the shot clock.
1 second left on the
shot
clock.
Can't let that happen.
Can't let it happen as Radovich misses a three down the other end, and a chance to cut this lead down to two or one now for Clarkson, trailing 39-35, 18:35 to go here in the second half. Herbert caught up in the air, gets over to Gerhardt. Gerhardt on the left side, guarded by Simon, one-on-one. Up top, Herbert has it. Herbert on the drive. Blocked by Radovich. Great play by Radovich.
A much better job by Radovich there. A lot more aggression, putting that big body in front of the opponent.
And a scoop to the hoop, a spin move from Wennerston. Count it, and the foul. Sorry, Geshek there, not Wennerston there.
A big play there by Genister.
Yeah, spinning and winning there is Geshek there, drawing the foul. Drawing the foul on Blake Gerhardt at the line now for one is Geshekler. He knocks it down. Bombers get that lead back up to seven. That's a great possession there to avert danger, pushing this lead back out.
That is a crucial score there, taking 3 points out of that possession.
Clarkson moving it around. Radovich on the defensive side, and a charging foul is called. Great play by Skyler Simon, sacrificing his body, drawing the charge on Reese Swedberg.
Swedberg arguing that call. I don't know what he's arguing about. A clear foul there, knocking him to the ground. And now an opportunity for Ithaca to add to this lead.
Yeah, Reese Swedberg looking like a bulldozer there, bulldozing right into Simon. Simon taking the contact, and the Bombers earning the possession. Sikoriak to Spellman up top. Spellman inside the Geshek there. Down low to Radovich. Radovich, two guys on him again. And a big man move by Luka Radovich.
Using that 6'6 body, climbing the ladder, putting the ball into the net. A big play there by Radovich.
After four straight to start the second half for Clarkson, it's five straight for the Bombers. Herbert on the drive. Kicks it out. Miles Ferguson, step back three. Off the mark, rebounded by Radovich.
16 points for Radovich on the day.
Simon, moving, grooving, Spellman, in stride, off the mark from three.
A good attempt there, another great job, patience, setting the ball up on the left side of the key, just over the rim, and not able to get points out of that one.
Yeah, it's still a good possession there from the Bombers, and now they transition back to the defensive side of the ball, 15 on the shot clock, 17:15 to go in the second half. Bombers lead at 45, 44-35, wide open three, Joe Lucas, book it! A three ball for Joe Lucas, and a quick timeout called. I'm not sure who called it. It might have been Clarkson looking to set up their defense.
An impressive play by Lucas there.
the graduate student from Watertown, Connecticut, 147 points, fourth on the team at 6'5", 190. One of those tall, stocky guys, but gets the job done. Very, very aggressive towards the net. 20 points first Bard on January 28th. And he's been a starter on this Clarkson team for five seasons, been through three head coaches. That's a great three there from Lucas. The Bombers still do lead 44-38 here at Ben Light Gymnasium. 17:07 to go in the second half. Both teams scoring great to start the second half. Eli, what are you looking for the Bombers to do out of this timeout? Coach Puri, a chance to draw something up. This is a big possession for the Bombers up by six.
As I said, take advantage of those opportunities that you have. We saw Radovich there, was right in front of, I believe it was Lucas, under the net. And the 6'6 guy gets bullied by the 6'2 guy. Looks like he almost gave up with 1 second left on the shot clock. You can't let that happen. Those were a big 2 points. In this type of game, the difference between a 6-point game and an 8-point game is giant. Just one of the examples of the plays and a couple miscommunication on one of the passes. I think it was Radovich to sign in when it bounced off his leg.
Yeah, and this seems to be a point of emphasis on the offensive side for the Bombers. Looking to get the ball inside the Luka Radovich. Sikoriak taking it up, kicks it to Geschichter. Geschichter, two guys on him, inside to Sinan. Sinan looking for Radovich, it's not there. Kicks it to the corner for Geschichter. Three ball, corner pocket. Look it. A three ball for Geschichter.
He's lived in that corner so far. The left corner doesn't get much better than that. Nothing but net.
The Bombers do love that corner three. You saw Logan went down the first half, taking some of those as Clarkson right back on the drive. Sweet move by Ryan Miles Ferguson.
That was an impressive play from Ferguson, going with his left hand. I don't know if he's a lefty or a righty, but over his head for a great couple of points.
And let's check in on that Skyler Sinan tracker as he knocks down the two-pointer. Give him six on the night. Bombers back up by nine, 49-40, 16:15 to go in the second half. Clarkson with possession going left to right. Miles Ferguson to Gerhardt, down low. Swedberg working on Radovich and those two fouls. Ferguson on the drive, seven on the shot clock. Gerhardt finds the open man. Swedberg, going to call that a two. Off the mark, rebounded by Geschichter.
Gerhardt is always open. Whenever I look at him, no one near him offensively, been very good. Maybe not necessarily with the shooting, but definitely a force to be reckoned with by Ithaca.
Yeah, an air ball there from Geschichter, looking to get something going in transition where the Bombers on that possession may not have been the best shot, kind of rushed there, as Clarkson will take back over possession, trailing 49-40 here at Ben Light Gymnasium. Geschichter guarding. Up top, stolen by Liam Spellman. Spellman one-on-one, the scoop to the hoop. Count it for Liam Spellman as the Bombers push the lead back up to double digits.
Talk about taking advantage. Joe Lucas was going up to knock the ball out of his hand. That's a dangerous play for both sides, but he didn't pull up, kept going, got the 2 points. Another great play by Ithaca.
And a foul there. They're going to get Skyler Sinan for it, I do believe.
A little bit of a flop there by Gerhardt.
Yeah, some
give him an Academy Award.
Give him an Academy Award indeed, as some boos ring in from the crowd. But Gerhardt will be going to the line for two shots. These are the first two free throws of the game for Clarkson.
Gerhardt, the team leader, with 300 points and shooting 456 from the floor. Gerhardt had 18 points in Ithaca's game earlier this season that we keep going back to, a big part of this team.
Yeah, Gerhardt shoots the ball 70.2% from the foul line on the year.
Radovich checking out for the Bombers as well.
Yeah, Radovich needing to stay in shape here. He has missed some time recently, so Coach Three does not want to overload him with minutes. The Bombers quickly on the floor. Sinan, Spellman to the corner. Sikoriak up top. Geschichter for three. You bet! A three ball for Geschichter. Nine quick points in the second half for Andrew Geschichter.
An impressive shot by him, and another big, big point taking advantage by Ithaca.
And a steal there from Liam Spellman ahead to Geschichter. Geschichter going to slow it down here to Sinan, to Spellman. Misses the layup inside Stern on the follow. Second follow, count it for Jack Stern.
Took three times, but he was able to get it in. Three times trying to go up. Stern, as we keep mentioning, big guy, listed at 6'7".
Third time's a charm there for Jack Stern as Clarkson brings it down the other way. Up top, Miles Ferguson, a fake shot off the mark. Spellman grabs the board.
I keep mentioning Miles Ferguson, very, very impressive player, but he cannot shoot from far back at all. He's really, really struggling with that so far today in this season. For right up against the net, an impressive player, he needs to do more of that.
We'll see if he gets to the hoop. It's a nice play by Spellman on the defensive side of the court to knock the ball out of play. A couple subs in here for Clarkson. Checking in is Teddy Fable and Jack Dalgetty, the star of the first half for Clarkson. And checking in for the Bombers, Zach Warwick and Logan Wendell, replacing Skylar Sinan and Andrew Geschichter. 13:59 to go. Bombers up 56-42 here at Ben Light Gymnasium, a big Liberty League clash. The Bombers at 13-7 on the year, 9-4 in Liberty League. Clarkson 5-15 with one of those five wins being against these Bombers. Inside, Fable, quick two off the bench.
Another good job by Fable using that big body, listed at 6'7", 225, to get up and grab a couple of points.
Sikoriak not looking to shoot the ball. Kicks the corner to Warwick, and the ball is taken away and stolen by Dalgetty. Chance for Clarkson to build on some momentum here.
A very bad pass there and some poor miscommunication. Clarkson takes advantage of it. Let's see if they can get some points.
Gerhardt takes a contested three, and it's taken by Spellman. The Bombers will look to push it here. Sikoriak into the front court, 24 on the shot clock. Bombers up by 12. Sikoriak to Spellman, to the corner to Warwick. Warwick not looking to shoot it. Takes a dribble inside the key, kicks it back out to Spellman, to the corner, inside to Jack Stern. Great ball movement, and a layup for Jack Stern.
Another impressive play by Jack Stern, who's leading this Bombers team so far in a majority of categories.
Yeah, Stern's been great when spelling Radovich, as there's a foul down low. Liam Spellman, the smaller guy, guarding Teddy Fravel inside. That's a fine foul for the Bombers to take there. Only their first team foul of the half, so Clarkson will inbound it underneath.
Coach Nobby did not like that one. That got him fired up. And George Sikoriak will come out of the game, and some more replacements being made by the Bombers.
A quick three from Dalgetty off the mark, rebounded by Ferguson. Kicks out to Herbert for three off the mark, rebounded by Dalgetty in the corner, and he throws it off of Spellman. Great play in the right corner, 19 seconds on the shot clock.
This Clarkson team, I don't know what it is, but they love shooting for threes. Three opportunities right there to set up the play, maybe get closer to the net, but they want to take those extra points shooting from three. They are actually second or third in the Liberty League, despite their spot in the standings in three-point attempts.
Yeah, and there's a quick turnover there from Clarkson as the Bombers will take over, going right to left. Up by 14, 58-44, 12:45 to go in the second half. Liam Spellman's got it up top for the Bombers to Wendell in the corner, to Stern down low. Not a single bounce on the deck, and count the two for Wennerstein.
It's been 3.5 minutes since Clarkson scored. This has been a big period, 60-44. Ithaca now leads in another big play there.
The Bombers up their lead to 16 as Herbert has it up top for Clarkson, going one-on-one on Warwick. Take it inside, and Warwick wins that battle. Warwick takes it away. On the move is Zach Warwick to Liam Spellman on the third left side. Score for Liam Spellman, and a quick timeout taken by Clarkson.
That is exactly how you set up that play. The bounce pass, the layup, leaping over the defender. When you don't have an opportunity, a perfect play by Ithaca. 62-44, they extend the lead.
This is their biggest lead of the game, up by 18. Coach Freed has to be thrilled with what is seen out of the halftime locker room from these Bombers. Andrew Geschichter, 9 quick points. Liam Spellman getting involved. The whole team getting involved. A great performance from the Bombers.
Absolutely. We've seen Geschichter, obviously, responsible for 12 points. Tristan Wennerson with 7. Luka Radovich with 16 so far. A lot of different players are contributing. Let's see, that's 10 players so far that have scored a point in this game for the Bombers.
And that's very impressive indeed. We've mentioned the Bombers' depth. They're showing it here, a chance to rotate guys in, and we'll see how many more guys get in if this lead continues to balloon. Once again, Bombers up 62-44, 12:20 to go here at Ben Light Gymnasium, second half. And the Bombers bring out a full court press for the first time in this game.
Wennerstein checks back in for the Bombers as well, as does Noah Downing.
Into the front court comes Clarkson, running their motion offense. Jack up top, Gerhardt guarded by Downing into the post. On the drive, outside the three-point line. 8 to go on the shot clock. Great defensive possession from the Bombers. And the three is off the mark from Clarkson. An offensive rebound is right there for Joe Fields. Outside is Gerhardt. 17 to go on the reset. Foul line is Frabel, guarded by Stern. They're going to call a block as Jack Stern was moving there. A great call by the referees, and two shots coming up for Teddy Frabel.
A good call there indeed. After some questionable calls, Coach Nobby trying to yell at his team to fire him up, yelling at the referees a little bit, because this is a big 2 points for Frabel. And again, what is it with this Clarkson team and their threes? They have the opportunity to go up, but they prefer to take that extra point. It looks like they just come back and shoot.
That is what basketball is turning into these past few years. Three-pointers and layups. No mid-range jump shots, and Clarkson is fitting that agenda here. Teddy Frabel at the line misses the first. He's only a 52.2% shooter on the year, and he lives up to his percentage there, splitting the pair. 62-45, Bombers lead. Zach Warwick, the senior, taking it up for the Bombers. Kicks it to Wendell up top. Wendell looking. Hits Winterston. Inside to Stern. Great move. Takes the contact and lays it in. Jack Stern for two.
Well, right. That's the reason he leads the team with 50 assists. Makes the right plays, passes it to the right people. A great setup there by Rec.
Bombers up by 19 points. Outside is Joe Field. Inside. Great look inside again from Clarkson. 14 to go on the shot clock. Joe Field turning down the three, taking the mid-range jumper in. Count it. 2 points there for Dante Jofield.
Wide open was Jofield. Looked like a little bit of blown coverage there. Going back to the right key, and an easy shot for him.
Winterson up top, kicks it over to Downing. Downing looking for someone to pass it to. Instead, he'll take his dribbles over to the left side. Wendell, deep three, doesn't want it. Pass it over to Downing. Quick kicks, one more. Winterson, three-pointer in the corner, no good. Stern on the offensive glass, goes up, no foul call. He's looking for the foul. He's upset with the referees. But Clarkson comes back down the other way.
That got Stern fired up, yelling at the opposing team, yelling at the referees there. Let's see if it can fire this Bombers team up a little bit.
As a three-pointer there from Gerhardt.
Another three attempt.
Another three-point attempt. They are down by 17. They are going to have to score somehow. As Wendell on the drive, off the mark. Stern cleanup duty. Stern puts it back up and in. The garbage man, Jack Stern up inside, cleaning up and putting it back in.
A great attempt by Wendell there, just bouncing off the back of the rim. But obviously, Stern, as you said, cleanup duty comes in, a close shot, takes advantage of the opportunity.
And Frabel on the drive, they're going to call it travel. Great defense there from Jack Stern, could have easily picked up his fourth foul, as now Luka Radovich will check in for Stern, who will be receiving a great ovation from his bench and his coach.
As we mentioned, with Radovich's injury, he missed the last five games with an ankle injury. So definitely something to monitor. Definitely the reason we've seen him in and out of the game, even though he's been so successful. 9,482 from the floor. 36 points this season is an Ithaca College debut on November 12th against Alpha 2. That is a way to introduce yourself.
Yeah, under 10 minutes to go, 9:38 to be exact. Bombers up 66-47 here in this Liberty League clash between Ithaca and Clarkson. Jofi on the drive, a little spin, but he can't win, as it's off the mark and rebounded by Zach Warwick.
Great rhymes there, Brandon.
Thank you,
sir. The spinny doesn't win. I love it.
They're going to call a blocking foul on the drive. They're going to call the foul on Joe Lucas. So the Bombers will inbound it on from underneath the hoop. Noah Downing will inbound it here. Bombers still up by 19.
I love the battle of the mustached men. Garrett Delaney and Zach Warwick with two big handlebar mustaches on each other. Love to see it.
Downing in the corner. He'll take the three. He won't make the three. Tips. They're going to call a foul on Radovich. That's going to be his third. Definitely something to monitor down the stretch. Three fouls on Radovich. Three fouls on Jack Stern.
Three fouls on Radovich, and that was a close call there for him. I don't know how much I agree with that one, as he was coming in front of the net, and it felt like it was the Clarkson player that came and cut him off.
There was not a necessary foul there. From Radovich, on the drive is Clarkson. Up top, Joe Field. Joe Field to Dougherty.
Surprised that wasn't called a foul there.
Yeah,
that was where Rhett kind of hit. It looked like he elbowed Lucas in the face a little bit.
Tough defense there from the Bombers. Seven on the shot clock as Mateo Sinan will check back in for Clarkson. He'll replace Joe Field. 7 on the shot clock. Clarkson got to draw something up quick here.
No Skyler sign in on the court. So it's the young number 5. The crowd getting very loud here. And it works. The crowd is into it. The bench is into it. And a very quick turnover there from Clarkson as the inbound pass went out of bounds.
The whole Ithaca bench stood up, was almost on the court, got really, really fired up there. As you said, it looks like it worked.
The energy definitely helps.
Warwick to Downing. Downing to Warwick. Warwick to the corner. Wendell, quick passes, and a corner three. Logan Wendell, look at
it. He threw up the peace sign in Joe Lucas's face after that three-pointer.
A little bit of swag from the
A little bit of aggressiveness. He loves that three-point on the right side, on the right of the key. Takes advantage of it there.
And a bad pass from Miles Ferguson. Downing chasing after it. And the Bombers recover it. Weatherston with the ball. Coach Marie is looking for a timeout. They don't see him. Radovich for three. That would have blown the roof off this place, but no good. Wendell to Warwick. Warwick to the corner. Weatherston. Weatherston for three. Off the mark. Wendell jumping the plan to
Downing. Yes, he went up there.
Radovich inside. The crowd loves the intensity from the Bombers here. They're going to call a foul. Not sure it's in the act of shooting. We will see. But Wendell and Radovich, both aggressive.
They say it was in the act of shooting, so that's going to be two for the Bombers.
Two free throws coming up for Luka Radovich. A fantastic effort from Logan Wendell, one of the smaller players on the floor, jumping above the defense, and now earned Luka Radovich 2 foul shots.
Now Clarkson coach Jeff Gorski is fired up, yelling at the official, really giving him an earful. And now Fareed getting in a conversation with the official about that timeout, I'm guessing it was, that wasn't called.
Yeah, Fareed was looking for the timeout. He now gets his timeout, 7:52 to go, as we'll send it down to Jaden Becker. Jaden, what you got for us?
Thank you, guys. And it's not too often anymore you see such a young coach out here on the sidelines coaching a collegiate program. Waheed is in his mid-30s, and you can argue he's like a Sean McVay and how he can relate to his players. Coach Waheed Fareed was recently seen on Instagram playing basketball with his team at practice, getting directly involved and putting up baskets in his own line. He's even had a couple good dribble moves out there that almost made a couple of his players touch ground. So he's definitely a baller in his own right. Some coaches can only dream to do so, while Fareed makes it a reality. Guys?
Yeah, I've heard from a couple of players on this team that Coach Fareed's practices are fun. They're high intensity, high movement, and we see it on the floor here. The Bombers love to score the ball. 69 points already with a chance for two more at the line.
He's the kind of coach that gets out there with the players, makes some shots, competes with them. Like Pete Carroll, I love it. That's the kind of thing that fires you up. Definitely easier when you can relate to your coach, a younger coach. He loves this team. His first season, but you definitely see there's a great bond here, a great relationship.
Yeah, definitely a great hire by the athletics department here. The team loves him, and they're going to actually change it. No shooting foul for Radovich. That might have been why Coach Fareed was fired up on the sidelines, as Zach will take it out underneath. The 5 on the floor for the Bombers. Radovich, Weatherston, Downing, Wendell, and Warwick. Inbounds play. Weatherston up off the mark, rebounded by Radovich. He goes back up and puts it in. The big man, Luka Radovich.
Another one-arm sling it over the head, and a big play by Radovich yet again.
Quickly on the floor is Mateo Sinan, dumping it off for an easy 2 to Marcus Boyer. And a quick 3 down the other end. Logan Wendell gives the 3 to the dome celebration. Bombers up by 25.
Wendell from way downtown runs up, dribbles it, immediately shoots. Doesn't wait for anything to come up. A great play by Wendell there.
Inside, great play by Zach Worth, taking the charge, sacrificing his body, and we're going down the other way. The Bombers up by 25 with 7:19 to go, 74-49. It'll be interesting to see what Coach Fareed does here. Some teams in the situation choose to slow down the pace, but we know the Bombers, we know they like to move the ball, move and groove. We'll see if they continue to push the pace, push the tempo.
The pace of this game says a lot about this Bombers team. Aggressive, fast, takes advantage of time, takes advantage of plays. Game's flying by.
Downing up top to Wendell in the corner. Logan Wendell to Warwick. Warwick for 3. You bet. Zach Warwick, a 3 ball.
Rolls around in the rim, but goes through. Another impressive 3-pointer there.
The Bombers have been crushing it from the 3-point line. It's another quick 2 for Marquise Boyer inside.
Boyer, ever since he came into this game about 5 minutes ago.
Oh, you count it for Tristan Larson. A great pass from Zach Wood, the team leader in assists, as you mentioned, Eli.
A bounce pass and a dunk. Exactly how you plan it, exactly how you play. Does not get much better than that. Crowd here at Ben Light the Gymnasium jumped up out of their seat.
Inside is Jack Dougherty for a quick two for Clarkson. The Bombers into the front court. Quick swing to the corner. Runnerston off the mark from three.
An aggressive pass there. That was Warek passing it over the heads of about five Clarkson players. 30 feet across the floor. The Bombers can't get any points.
Off the mark is Herbert. Rebounded by Radovich. Taken by Warek. Quickly had to Wendell. No dribbles. Into the hoop. It goes. Logan Wendell from three.
Wendell loves those three-pointers. As a freshman, two Liberty League rookies of the week, second on the team in three-pointers, fifth on the team with 148 points. That's why.
Stolen away by Wendell. Knocked out of bounds by Sinan. The Bombers will retain possession as the Bombers do empty their bench a little bit here. Into the game for the first time, Aiden Holmes, a first year, and Alex Barron, a senior.
Radovich coming out of the game, and Warek.
Coach Fareed feels confident up here with the Bombers up 82-53, 5:30 to go in the ball game. Noah Downing with it up top. Kicks over to Tristan Lennerston, to Logan Wendell. Will he shoot it right away? No. Wendell dishes it off to Downing. Downing to the corner, Holmes. Holmes to Lennerston. Lennerston open 16-footer. You bet. Lennerston knocked it down. The Bombers have their largest lead of the game at 31.
Lennerston looking very, very impressive down the stretch. 11 points so far in this one.
And a quick two down the other way from Jack Dougherty. Lennerston, risky pass to Holmes. Holmes looking to drive, and they're going to call him for a charging violation. Could have called him for a charge there, a travel there.
Fareed is not happy getting up in the face of the referee yet again. Giving him quite the earful for good reason, following him to the right side of the court. Definitely not happy about this one. And that says a lot about Fareed and about this team, that despite being up by 19 points, so much aggression, so much fire by the head coach and this squad.
Off the mark with the three ball of the Bombers, and Clarkson pushes back down the other way. Frankie Rainville to Boyer inside, out for three. It's good. Malachi Harris, we've seen him hit a couple threes in this ballgame.
Harris checked in recently and has looked impressive, as you said, with two threes in his short stint in the game so far.
Holmes on the drive to Wendell to Alex Barron. Backup shot to Holmes, who bends on him to shoot it. The first steal with the jumper. The first two of the game for Aiden Holmes.
Holmes, primarily a defensive player, is where he's looked the best on the court this season. As you said, a first year, not a lot of playing time. He took a gap year last semester to wait and to play with Wahid Nabi, taking advantage of that.
Downing on the drive, no good with the layup.
Downing only 5'9", 165. And on that time right there, he was going up against Dalgetty, who's 6'5". So obviously Clarkson takes the ball and keeps possession, but then Ithaca takes it back.
Lennerston with the ball over to Downing. Downing into Lennerston. Wide open corner, Wendell. But they're going to call a Bombers timeout. Looks like they're going to bring in some more subs, clearing off the bench.
Wendell right before Nabi called that timeout. That almost an open net, an opportunity to go up for the layup easily. But a timeout called, regardless, by the Bombers with 3:22 remaining. They lead 86-58.
Yeah, despite this massive lead for the Bombers, Coach Fareed still has that intensity in the huddle. It looks like the Bombers will be bringing in a few more players from the bench. Looks like Tommy Carver will be checking in, as well as Blake Haber and Bryce Levitree for the Bombers to go along with Holmes and Barron.
Frankie Rainville checking back in for Clarkson as well as Nick Budesheim.
So everybody on the Bombers has played today. We'll see if everybody can score for the Bombers. Tommy Carver has it up top. Carver with a left-handed dribble inside the Barron. Barron might have gotten away with the travel, and now they're going to call the travel on Alex Barron. 3:13 to go. Clarkson to inbound. Mateo Sinan still in the game. So one of the Sinan brothers into the game. Sinan with it up top. Kicks it. Down low Boyer. Clarkson continues to move the ball around. Inside. Outside. Boyer with it. Malachi Harris now with it. Down low to Boyer. Boyer guarded by Barron. Boyer puts it up off the mark. Rebounded by the Bombers. The Bombers still pushing the pace here with 86 points.
That's Bryce Bribetree, who came into the game the first year, who brought the ball back into the Bombers' possession.
Great block there by Mateo Sinan. Malachi Harris on the three-point line turns it down, kicks it to Sinan in the corner. Kynan a shot fake, a drive, wide open. Malachi Harris off the mark. Sinan the rebound, and he puts the layup in. A two-point shot for Mateo Sinan.
Sinan with cleanup duty there after another big three-point attempt from the left side by Clarkson.
Tommy Carver for three, off the mark. Rebounded by Clarkson and a foul on the Bombers. That'll go against Blake Haber.
Haber, a sophomore, just checked into the game. He's only gotten 10 minutes this season. As you said, every player has checked in so far for the Bombers today. They lead by 26 points.
Bombers up 86 to 60. 2:07 to go here in this one from Ben Light Gymnasium. Boyer with the ball for Clarkson. Runs the offense, kicks it up top, Sinan for three. Short. Rebounded by Alex Barron.
A nice job by Barron there, preventing an offensive rebound using his size, 6'4", and getting up there to steal the ball.
Holmes gets to his spot, misses the jumper, rebounded by Rainville. Rainville pushing for Clarkson. Over to Budesheim. Bodies on the floor, wide open man in the corner. It's Malachi Harris for another three. You bet. Malachi Harris drains another three ball for Clarkson.
Again, he loves that spot on the court in the right corner, or the left corner, the far side from us up in the broadcast booth.
Yeah, sweet looking lefty stroke as the two-pointer from the foul line is good from Haber. Haber joins the scoring party, as now 11 different Bombers, make it 12 different Bombers have scored as Sinan on the drive. Take it away by Haber. Haber's looking to push. He's got a man up ahead. Spin, move, and count it. Bryce Bribetree giving the Bombers 90 points on the day.
I bet that was Frankie Rainville who gave up after a spin move on him, gave up a little bit, allowed that point. I bet he's going to hear it from Jeff Gorski, the coach for Clarkson, after this game.
Bombers up by 27, 45 seconds to go. Pass off the side of the backboard. We'll give it back to the Bombers.
A nice deflection there by Aiden Holmes, pushing it into the backboard and giving the Bombers possession yet again.
And one more offensive possession here for the Bombers. The two Bombers on the floor have not scored yet. Tommy Carver and Alex Barron. Let's see if this play goes to one of those two. 13-second difference shot in game clock. 90-63, the Bombers lead. Haber for three. You bet. Blake Haber puts the Bombers up by 30. 93-63.
You could tell he wanted that one. Fired him up. Always getting a young player in the game. And getting a three-pointer in a situation like this must feel good.
Mateo Sinan. Count it. And one foul shot. Sorry, two foul shots. Count the goal for Sinan. One foul shot to come. You did hear another big cheer from the crowd, of course. The Sinan family in attendance for this battle between the Sinan brothers. Mateo will look to put one last point on the board. And it's off the mark. Rebounded by Barron. And the Bombers can just dribble it out as Tommy Carver crosses half court. The fans begin to serenade the players. Bombers win it 93-65. A very impressive performance here at Ben Light Gymnasium.
A very impressive performance indeed. Obviously, the score a little bit back and forth at the beginning of the game. They got fired up. They turned on the Jets. They made the plays they needed to at the end of